Ultimate Super Wine Girl Angela Aiello joins us now with wines from Oregon, specifically from wine pioneer Ken Wright. So yes. What makes somebody a wine pioneer?
Great question. I mean, he helped create the Oregon wine industry and specifically some of the AVAs in it. And so he has been making wine for 45 years, particularly Pinot Noir, which we're looking at today. And he's really the icon of the region.
Okay. Now, you know me, I'm more of a white wine drinker.
Yes.
But you're going to you say these are the perfect red wines for me.
I mean, Pinot Noir is the perfect red wine for everybody.
Yeah.
But Ken Wright Pinot Noir really excels in the premium side of Pinot Noir.
Like, and Oregon, these are pricey wines.
Definitely. They're meant for the real wine enthusiast.
Okay.
And Oregon's a really, really interesting place. It falls in the Pacific Northwest, so you have volcanic history, you have marine sediment. You're crafting really amazing wines from a plant and a place and a grape that really suits this area.
Okay. And you say that these wines are 100% Pinot Noir.
Yes, grapes. They have the Oregon promise on the back. So in many places in the U.S., you can actually only need to have 75% of the grape inside the bottle to put the grape on the bottle. These are 100% Pinot. And actually, Ken came up with the Oregon Promise, and that's on the back of the label. You see that as 100% Pinot Noir.
Okay, so what's the first wine?
Okay, so Ken Wright produces 13 single vineyards, and so the very first one we're going to have is from the Willamette Valley. So give it a swirl and a smell. I have these beautiful Pinot glasses here.
Because I'm so used to drinking white wine. Okay, so I can hold it
hold it by the stem or the bulb if you want. I know, this is very delicate, and you want to swirl, and you want to smell it. So the Willamette Valley is very interesting as well because it's a large place. You know, it's a small place in the world, but it is a large region within Oregon. But only 5% of this area is meant for premium Pinot. So Pinot is a tight clustered grape. It's very shy.
That's very nice.
But it gives you that real sense of place. Yes. It's a luxurious finish. It has this magnolia
it's not
and rose.
Exactly.
Neutral oak on this wine too. Mm-hmm. So really wonderful. You're going to see this actually in a lot of restaurants around Toronto by the glass or by the bottle. Really quite lovely too. So the Willamette.
And then the second one?
Okay, the second one we're headed over to here.
You've swirled it around here. So it's a little thicker.
Yes, there's three tiers of Ken Wright. I think what you're saying is the color is a little more dense. It's true. We're looking at some new oak, 10% new oak on this wine. You're getting a little bit more berries on this as well. And this comes from a volcanic area. So we're looking at sort of the mother rock. You know, we're headed into Mother's Day, but the mother rock, when vines really stretch down underneath the ground, they absorb microbiology and nutrients to really craft premium wines.
Okay.
So this is volcanic,
nice
which
too.
You see on the label here too. It looks like the vine is headed all the way down to the mother rock, which is great. So he has three tiers, the Willamette, we've got the AVA series, and then the single vineyard. So he's walked around his vineyard, his entire area, and said, these are the plots that actually really make sense. You know, and he's crafted them all very uniquely and individually. So that is the Eola Hills, Amity Hills. And this one is the Shea Vineyard, which is a very special wine as well. So the Sheas, it's a great couple out in Willamette. They actually planted grapes before they were, before wine country was a thing.
Okay.
And then Ken helped revitalize this whole vineyard with nutrition-based farming, you know, really kind of helping to premiumize the area. And now it's the finest area in all of Oregon for wine.
I gotta say, I like this one the best.
Oh, nice, the volcanic.
Okay, the price is here. Let's go.
$58 for the Willamette. The Eola Amity is $88. And then the Shea Vineyard is $150.
Okay, so I don't have really expensive taste. I have middle of the road taste. That's very nice. Not available at LCBO, but
these are available at GibsonFamilyGRP.com, Gibson Family Group, and you can buy them and have them delivered to your home for that very, you know, wonderful evening, very luxurious addition to your cellar.
Okay.
And as a gift.
Yeah. Angela, thanks very much.
Thank you so much.